After 6 long months, the Chief Justice of Fontaine, the Hydro Sovereign NEUVILLETTE himself, has finally got the first rerun. This Hydro Kamehameha user is waiting for us to be declared guilty and use all the primos on him. So today's video we will be discussing his gameplay mechanics, best artifacts, weapons and team builds. Without wasting any more time, let's get started. Being a Catalyst user, his normal attack consists of 3 continuous strike, dealing Hydro damage with attack multipliers. This attack deals very little damage, but his main source of damage comes from his charge attack, unleashing a strong Hydro pump, dealing Hydro damage through the path, which is scaled on NEUVILLETTE's max HP. This lasts for around 4 seconds and take a considerate amount of time to charge up. Consuming 3 droplets, either created from his skill of burst, or from Hydro Traveler's skill, instantly make him use his charge attack. Using skill deals a single instance of Hydro damage based on his HP, followed by a Pneuma hit, that happens every 10 seconds. After casting the skill, 3 droplets are also generated which last for 15 seconds, which can only be used by NEUVILLETTE's charge attack. Then we have his burst, dealing AoE Hydro damage on HP scaling for 1 wave, followed by 2 weaker waterfall damage, creating 6 droplets. His skill and burst is very straightforward mechanics, but essential, creating droplets, thus helping his enhanced charge attack gameplay, which is his main source of damage. His charge attack pass through enemy which makes him a good AoE damage dealer. But we have to be considerate as this charge attack continuously drains his HP while active. On the other hand, consuming his droplets regenerates his HP. This comes into play while using artifacts like Murekausi Hunter Set or utilizing Farina's buff, and make him a self-sustainable unit. His droplet absorption has a good range as well. While using charge attack you will also be locked in this camera angle, but can also hover around, and position yourself for better damage, or avoid enemy attacks. Only downside is this state does not have a interruption resistance and can easily be knocked back, costing his charge attack to stop. You can easily dash cancel to avoid attacked, but this costs the damage uptime. The constellation makes this irrelevant, but later, on his constellation topic. Moving on to his passive talent, his Ascension 1 passive, when any character on the party does a Hydro-related reaction, NEUVILLETTE got a stack of past Draconic Glory. Each stack increases the charge attack by certain amount. Note here is this stack can happen per unique reaction. Even if a same reaction happened twice, the stack only get refreshed, not adding a new stack. To track this there is visual sign for 3 stacks, which is the max number he can have. Stack can also be triggered by on-field or off-field characters by any party member or even enemy's own elemental auras. Since this stack's last 30 seconds this makes it permanent bonus as long as you keep making Hydro reactions. Now for the second passive he get a Hydro damage bonus over a certain percentage above the 30,000 HP mark he have. And now for the exploration passive he gets a movement speed bonus underwater, making him the best Hydro otter there is. So to sum up, his talent priority is, normal attack, charge attack, then followed by his skill and burst which you can level equally. Now talking about the constellation, his C1 gives an extra stack of A1 passive and gains interruption resistance. Which is very useful if your team have 2 Hydro character and do only 2 Hydro reaction, and having no shield makes his team building more easier. C2 makes his Draconic stacks also gather crit damage of maximum of 42% which overall increases his damage by a significant amount. C3 increase his normal and charge attack talent by 3 which is also a good bump in his personal damage. C1 and C3 are good stopping point, who is more conservative about their premos is his next meaningful upgrade is his C6. C4 generates water droplet if he healeth, though this can trigger every 4 seconds. This is a decent quality of life upgrade though its use case increase in C6. C5 increase his burst level by 3. And finally C6 make the water droplets absorbed by the charge attack extend the duration of the Hydro pump by 1 second each, and add a small Hydro pump considered as charge attack, though this makes his field time a lot more, and change his play style. Now let's talk about his artifacts. His general artifact will be HP Sand Hydro Damage Goblet and Crit Helmet depending on your crit stat maintaining 1-to-2 ratio on crit rate and damage. You can switch to HP Goblet also, if your team buff gives you so much damage bonus. Now for the substat, aim for crit HP and ER. His ER should be around 150 if you have 1 Hydro character in the team, as his burst cost 70. This is rough estimation as some weapons and team will vary the ER needs and for the artifact set. His best in slot is 4-piece Marekhaus Hunters by a significant margin, as his most of the damage comes from his charge attack and can easily utilize the crit stacking. Just look for the crit damage as the set already gives a lot of crit rate. Next full set would be 4-piece of Heart of Depths. Other 2-piece can be HP sets and Hydro damage combined, while farming for the best set. Now let's see the best weapons for NEUVILLETTE. His best free-to-play weapon can be Prototype Amber, followed up by Ballad of the Boundless, and Thrilling Tales of Dragon. From a low spender perspective, Sacrificial Jade can be best 4-star and even very competitive to R1 signature weapon. Widseth can also be very decent option as for the raw crit sat and decent passive dot for the 5-star. Tomb of the Eternal Flow is best weapon as it is his signature after all, providing a crit stat HP and charge attack related bonus and energy recharge. Any other crit 5-star can also be very viable options. Now talking about team comp, his team mainly consists of various elemental reactions. As he is HP scaling DPS, attack buff is not necessary, rather than boosting hydro damage and hydro related buffs is more useful. So having Kazuha or Sucrose or any VV wielding Anemo character and then having off-field character providing elements off-field, is much more appreciated. At C0 he also needs shields for stagger resistance. Also characters like Shinkawi and Yelan is not recommended as NEUVILLETTE's charge attacks can't trigger their bursts. Rather, Farina helps his damage go even higher. Also being Catalyst user he can be played as the main driver for any Vape or Hyperbloom team while dealing good amount of personal damage. Overall NEUVILLETTE is very versatile unit with his fun gameplay and very good damage output. Let me know in the comments how you are enjoying the gameplay and the character design of this Hydro Sovereign and Chief Justice of Fontaine.